Good afternoon, Penn High School, and welcome to this edition of PNN. I'm Maxwell Bernstein.
And I'm Cora Estrada. Let's hop into today's announcements for the day, today, November 13th. But first, let's see the biggest Penn news story of the week.
On November 11th at approximately 2:40 p.m., a water pipe burst over the hallway where rooms 153, 155, and a custodial office are located. PNN reporter Ashley Katanzright interviewed Mrs. Demsky and Mrs. Hensley, part of the custodial staff here at Penn High School, about the problem.
Hours. Yeah. By the time we get it dry and clean, because you got to shampoo it, everything's got to be done now once you get the water cleaned up.
It probably won't get turned on till late tonight. They've got to get the pipe material to fix the pipe, and that'll take maintenance a few hours to get done. But as they're doing that, we'll be cleaning the carpets and wiping down the walls and stuff. So hopefully late tonight it'll be back on.
For PNN and Ashley Katanzright, I'm Gary Babcock.
Welcome back. In the coming weeks, you'll see a handful of turkeys running around the hallways. The annual Turkey Leg fundraiser is just around the corner, so prepare yourself. You may see your teachers wearing shorts in the middle of November.
It's better to light a candle than to curse the darkness. This is the motto for the Penn Amnesty Group. If you're interested in helping change the world, Penn Amnesty meets every Thursday afternoon in room 200.
Kingsmen Against Cancer will be having a meeting on Thursday, November 19th from 7:45 to 8:05 in room 108. At this meeting, the club will be making Thanksgiving-themed crafts. For more information, please email pennkac@gmail.com. And now let's head over to our weather, then Mr. Joe Brisley for an update with this weather report.
Good day, Penn High School, and happy Friday. I'm PNN weatherman Joe Brisley, and on this Friday the 13th, I want to give you all a little extra luck to get you through the weekend. It's probably third block for you right now, so you only have an hour or two left to survive. For now, though, I have your weather for today and the next few days. This morning, we woke up to a couple of showers outside, although nothing quite as bad as that pipe burst back on Wednesday. It'll be 44 and very windy when you're heading home, though, so just that might dry you off for Saturday. On tomorrow, we get up to the low 50s for our high, and we'll be bright and sunny outside. The sun stays with us into Sunday, appropriately, as we warm up to nearly 60 degrees. Remember a few weeks ago when 60 was too cold for us? Me too. Heading into next week, we have highs mainly into the 50s, but getting up to 61 on Tuesday. However, for both Tuesday and Wednesday, we have a chance of even more showers. So perhaps those darn pipes will burst again. That's all the weather I have for you, Penn High School. Have a great weekend, and now back to the desk.
Thanks, Jay Bruce.
There will be a women's track meeting on Monday, November 16th at 3:30 in the cafeteria. If you can't make the meeting, please see Coach Fletcher or email him at jfletcher@phm.k12.in.us. Also, boys track winter conditionings for long distance runners will start next Monday the 16th from 3:45 to 5. Be sure to attend if you plan on running track in the spring. And now we'll head to an interview on Ski Club. Stay tuned.
Good morning, Penn High School. I am PNN reporter Matt Kelly, and I am joined in the PNN studio by Mrs. Brown. She runs the Penn Ski Club. Thanks for you joining us today.
Thank you. It's nice being here, Matt.
So what is Ski Club for?
Ski Club is a group of students who like to ski and snowboard, and we go to Swiss Valley on Tuesday nights in January and February.
And how do you apply?
There's an application that you can get from me, or I also have them in the bookstore. And actually, you should be receiving an email from in your student mail account that you can get the information, fill it out, and turn it into the bookstore with your payment.
How much does it cost to join the club?
It varies. We have different packages, but you can join for as little as $140 for a ski lift ticket. If you need to get rentals, it's a few more dollars, and you can also get a season pass. If you have a season pass already, you still may join the ski club.
When does ski club happen?
We start January the 5th, as soon as we come back from winter break, and we go through February 9th. Unless we have a snow day, then we might go a little bit longer.
Are you allowed to use a snowboard if you don't have a pair of skis?
Of course. You can rent a snowboard even if you don't have one, but Swiss Valley allows you to ski or snowboard there, and you can rent both.
On what nights does Ski Club go to Swiss Valley?
We go Tuesday nights in January and February.
And how long does the club ski each night?
We leave here at Penn approximately at 4:30, and we return back to Penn about 10 o'clock. So we get there about 5:30-ish, and we leave at 9 o'clock. So you ski between 5:30 and 9 o'clock.
So why should people join the club?
It's a way to get outside and have fun in the wintertime instead of sitting inside, just watching TV with nothing to do. I enjoy skiing. I probably ski 3 or 4 times a week at Swiss Valley and other places in Michigan. And I really hate snow, but it gets me out there and I really enjoy it.
Okay, we wish this ski club lots of fluffy white snow this winter, but not too much like this year. Now back to you.
Thanks, guys.
ASL clubs will meet before and after school on Wednesday from 7:55 to 8 o'clock. And AM and 3:25 to 3:35 AM. And if you have further questions, please email pennaslclub@gmail.com.
Penn Med Club will be having its first meeting on Tuesday, November 17th in room 212 from 3:30 to 4:15. If you have any further questions, please email the account at pennmedclub@gmail.com. Well, we will head over to T-Cleft with all your sports.
Hey, Penn High School, I'm Tyler Clifton here to give you your sports updates. Women basketball won easy over South Bend Riley, 79-12 Wednesday night. Tyler Chambers and Cameron Burr scored 14 points each. Caitlin Marini scored 12. Last night, the Lady Kingsmen beat LaPorte 61-31. Caitlin Marini led the team with 14 points. Lindsey Klein scored 12. Kim Solomon scored 9. Tim Burr scored 8. And Claire Carlton scored 6. Come out and support your Kingsmen football team in semi-state against Carmel at 7:30 tonight. Well, it looks like all the sports we have for you today, Penn. I'm Tyler, and now back to the desk.
Thanks, Cheese.
Well, that's all we have for you today, Penn.
Be sure to visit our website at pnn.phmschools.org.
And follow us on Twitter at Penn News Network.
From PNN, I'm Cora.
And I'm Maxwell Bernstein. Have a wonderful weekend.